tonic of wildness. To wade sometimes in marshes where the bittern and the meadow hen lurk, and hear the booming of the snipe. To smell the whispering sedge where only some wilder and more solitary fowl builds her nest, and the mink crawls with its belly close to the ground. At the same time that we're earnest to explore and learn all things, we require that all things be mysterious and unexplorable, that land and sea be infinitely wild, unsurveyed, and unfathomed by us, because unfathomable. We can never have enough of nature. We must be refreshed by the sight of inexhaustible vigor, vast and titanic features. The seacoast with its wrecks, the wilderness with its living and its decaying trees, the thundercloud, and the rain which lasts 3 weeks and produces freshets. We need to witness our own limits transgressed, and some life pasturing freely where we never wandered.